You've already learned how to make your own variables and use them. So now we're going to learn about two special variables, mouseX and mouseY. Now, you never have to make these variables yourself, and in fact, you shouldn't, because they already exist. You see, the program sets a value of these variables behind the scenes, making sure that value of mouseX is always the X position of your mouse, and the value of mouseY is always the Y position of your mouse. This makes it really easy to do cool, interactive things based on the user's mouse position. Let's look at this ellipse that I'm drawing here. So right now, I'm always drawing it at 200, 200. If I use mouseX and mouseY, these special variables, then I could actually draw it at mouseX and mouseY. Now, if I move my mouse over the canvas, you can see ellipse is always being drawn where my mouse is. So it follows my mouse around. That's pretty cool. Can you tell what I'm drawing? Whee! If you're going to use mouseX and mouseY, you've got to make sure that you use them inside the draw function. Because look what happens if we move these two lines of code outside the draw function. You see? Now, this code here, it only gets run once. So this ellipse is only drawn once, and it's drawn wherever my mouse happened to be at the very, very beginning of the program. So that's why we need to have it inside the draw function, because the draw function is this function that's called repeatedly over and over while our program is running. So we want that when it gets called, then it looks at what the current value, mouseX and mouseY is, and then it draws the ellipse at that position. If you think about it, it's actually very similar to an animation. It's changing over time, just in a different way. Okay, so now we can do all sorts of fun things. So what if, instead of drawing it in mouseX and mouseY, I drew it at mouseX still, but then I fixed mouseY at something like 300. And now you can see the ellipse only follows my X coordinate, ignoring whatever I do on the Y. Yeah, so then what if I now draw it at mouseX and mouseY, we'll bring that back, but I get rid of the background and just comment that out. Okay, whoo, now look, now we've got this funky paintbrush kind of thing. That's pretty awesome. Or I could even switch these variables. Let me bring back in our background. Okay, so I'll switch these variables here, mouseY, mouseX, and then see what happens. Okay, now it just feels really, really, really weird because I've got these mouse controls that are doing opposite of what I expect them to do. But that's cool. You can imagine even making a whole game which is about trying to draw something or do something while using inverted mouse controls. So, that's it for mouseX and mouseY. Really pretty fun. Enjoy!